Food ingestion starts with the mouth. The function of the mouth is to select and acquire the food, and if it is solid, break it into small pieces by chewing, and initiate digestion by mixing it with salivary enzymes. The form of insect mouthparts depends on the nature of the food eaten. There are basically two types of mouthparts, chewing and piercing-sucking. The most primitive orders of wingless insects, as illustrated by the springtail and firebrat shown here, all have chewing mouthparts, suggesting that chewing mouthparts constitute the least specialized primitive form. Chewing mouthparts are for biting and breaking solid food. The grasshopper chewing mouth will illustrate the general structure and organization of the insect mouth. The broad, flap-like labrum is the outermost structure and acts as a flexible upper lip covering the mouth. Below the labrum, paired mandibles are highly sclerotized, unsegmented jaws that cut solid food and crush it, similar to vertebrate teeth. The mandibles have a distal incisor cusp for cutting the food and a proximal molar cusp for crushing the food by chewing. Paired maxillae are located below the mandibles and have finger-like palps. The maxillae and their palps help the mandibles hold and manipulate the food. Between the maxillae and above the labium is the hypopharynx, a tongue-like structure to facilitate directing food into the pharynx and swallowing. The labium is a plate-like structure with palps on each side that covers the mouth as a lower lip. Chemoreceptors for tasting the food are present on all the mouth parts except the mandibles. Here is a side view to show the internal arrangement of the mouth. The various mouthparts originated ancestrally from external appendages that surrounded the true mouth to form a preoral cavity. The preoral cavity is divided into an anterior sabarium and a posterior salivarium, into which the paired labial salivary glands empty through a common duct. Food is chewed and mixed with saliva, then forced by the maxillae and hypopharynx up into the mouth for swallowing. In the next scene, we will show some of the mouthpart adaptations that insects have developed that allow them to feed on such wide varieties of food.